It starts with Southern Miss alum and football legend Brett Favre, who only wanted to build a volleyball facility. Little did everyone know that this would lead to the largest public embezzlement case in Mississippi history. USM's Wellness Center started construction in 2017, with Brett Favre and nonprofit organizer Nancy New overseeing most of the project. The project started out with $4 million, but the price quickly grew as funds were secretly funneled from News welfare-based nonprofit organization Mississippi Communication Education Center, which received millions a year from temporary assistance for needy families. The funds were intended for low-income families in the poorest state in America, yet instead went into building the state-of-the-art facility. Millions upon millions of dollars were frequently funneled into this construction. Favre himself received over $1 million for speaking engagements and promotions that never happened. While most state officials would have caught and stopped this financial misuse, the head of the Mississippi Department of Human Services, John Davis, was actually in on the scandal, having been bribed by Nancy New. Davis and even members of his family were given these welfare-intended funds to fly first class and visit professional wrestler friends at luxury drug rehabilitation centers in California. The scandal goes well beyond Favre, New, and Davis, extending to former Mississippi governor and Southern Miss alum Phil Bryant. Texts reveal that he was in incessant contact with New and Favre, working out ways to build the facility. Bryant's close friend and state auditor Shad White finally caught on to the scandal, but many are wondering why he didn't catch it sooner and why he left out particular information about Bryant in his now-released documents. When questioned about the scandal, the Office of the President and USM Communications declined to comment or discuss. Despite the bad publicity that those involved have been receiving, one person is still pledging innocence, Brett Favre. Though Favre has stated that there were no immoralities committed in the creation of this facility, the convictions and arrests currently in place for New, her son Zachary New, and John Davis say otherwise. John Davis has currently pleaded guilty and has been sentenced to 32 years in prison. After being arrested in 2020 for their role in the scandal, Nancy and Zachary New are awaiting sentencing but could face over 75 years in prison. This is a developing story with new details related to the scandal coming out in the media every single day. Southern Miss Student Media will continue to provide updates and information on this unprecedented scandal. Abigail Troth, SM2 News.